want to become a wildlife biologist? I came up with a bunch of questions that you should ask yourself before you go into this career. Hi, I am Dr. Stephanie Shuttler, a wildlife biologist, and my channel is all about empowering scientists and inspiring everyone to care about conservation. I am writing a book on becoming a wildlife biologist, and long story short, expectations don't necessarily match reality. People often message me telling me they want a job exactly like mine, where they can be outdoors all the time, but they really don't have a good understanding of what wildlife biology is like. I've talked about that a lot in this video series, so if you haven't seen the other videos, make sure you check them out. But today I just want to go over some important questions to really know if you want to embark on this path. So I'm just going to go ahead and read them and then add some commentary as we go along. So the first one is reading and writing in scientific papers. Do you like doing this? As an undergrad, have you had experience doing this? If not, then look for scientific publications through Google Scholar, ResearchGate, or through the open access peer-reviewed journals. There are a lot of free publications out there, and I'll link to a video below on how you can actually do this. This is the main way that scientists communicate. As a scientist, you're probably going to be publishing a lot of studies. At least if you go to graduate school, this is definitely a big part of it. And you will have to read the literature all the time. In graduate school, we often have lab meetings, and one of the things we do is read paper every single week. So this is really something you have to get used to and that you have to enjoy. If you don't understand everything, don't worry about this point. Just see if it's something that you think you could enjoy over time, because it is hard. You have to learn how to read a scientific paper. It takes some practice. Do you like figuring out why things are the way they are? Are you always asking questions about the natural world? This is what we do as scientists. We answer unanswered questions out there. We ask and answer them. Does that make sense? In school, you're taught that science is basically like memorizing facts, but that's not what it is at all. It's really investigations, figuring out why things are the way they are. Do you look at an animal and wonder why it's doing that behavior, or why it's colored that way? Why do the males look different than the females? This is the type of mindset that you have to have as a scientist, just constantly questioning the natural world and wanting to understand the answers of those questions. That's really what drives science. Do you like working with data, especially statistics? You may think you like working with data, but really, science is, especially now, really dealing with advanced statistics. I work in camera trapping. These camera traps produce hundreds to thousands of images per camera trap. Multiply that times at least the 20 camera traps that we need for a study. Analyzing all of those data requires complex statistical models. That's really where the direction of the field is going. So if you enjoy math classes, if you can take statistics classes, this will help you determine if you want to go into wildlife biology. Do you like it when someone gives you a job with little direction, when you have no one specifically telling you what to do step by step? This is especially true for graduate school. I envision graduate school to be like an apprenticeship where I was learning alongside my advisor. Now, I didn't expect my advisor to do everything for me or hold my hand all along the way, but graduate school is really, a lot of it is figuring stuff out by yourself. There was an article out recently with surveying graduate students, and I think the most common response was that graduate students see their advisor an hour a week, or maybe less than an hour a week. I can't remember, but I'll post that in the description below. You're really gonna have to figure out projects by yourself, and your lab mates will help you too. But it's a lot of figuring out by yourself. It's really, that's a big part of graduate school. And later on, as you go on as a scientist, as a research scientist, that's what you'll be doing. Learning things completely on your own. For example, if you were given a new computer program to learn about all on your own, would this be something you enjoy doing? Again, you're going to be doing a lot of this on your own because science is new. We're constantly trying new methods. I have people in my lab who are working on new statistical models to analyze data in different ways. So no one's ever done this before. So really you have to be comfortable or excited by or interested in trying to do things really on your own and teach yourself. In wildlife biology, we rely on the statistical program R, which is more or less a black box. It used to be more of a black box, but you have to code your own models and your own analyses. Yes, there is code out there to help you, and there are books to help you, but everyone's study is so different that it really requires a lot of you trying to figure out exactly how to code this and how to get the analyses done in the way that you want them done. When I was a graduate student in a genetics lab, there were constantly new genetics programs out there and you had to learn them. Your advisor didn't necessarily know them. I was doing social networks, something that my advisor had never done before. It's something that nobody in my university, or at least in the biology and wildlife departments had ever done before. And I had to read the manual, figure it out, make my data work. So that's really what graduate school is like. Solving statistical problems where there is no right answer, coding computer programs. I touched on some of those. With the statistics, it's not like there's always a clear-cut way of doing it. In school, in math class, there was usually just like one way to get to the answer. But it's not like that in wildlife biology and science. So you're gonna have to weigh carefully different ways to analyze your data and understand what those imply, the different biases associated with those different methods. Are you okay with things taking a long time? It takes years to publish studies. Years, it takes years. So my PhD research, your PhD research will definitely take a long time. It'll take anywhere between 5 to 7 years and then you'll get publications out of that. But even stuff that I did in my postdoc at the museum, I started in 2014. I got the publication out in 2018 or 2019 around them. Now we were collecting data that whole time, but still the process is really slow. I submitted a paper to a journal last year, and here we are in May, and I haven't even heard the results of this paper yet, so I haven't even received feedback on it. So it can take a year from when you submit your paper just to get it published. You have to be very, very patient as a scientist. And then finally, for a wildlife biologist, are you okay with difficult field situations? Mosquitoes, ticks, monkeys dropping poop on you. I have literally seen that in tech position descriptions. Long days. Field work it sounds fun, but it's honestly really difficult. I did most of my field work in Gabon, and developing countries presents its own set of challenges. A lot of the field work isn't very sexy. Yes, I observed elephants in the field, but I also spent time being stuck in the mud, walking through the forest, finding no dung samples. This one part, I was on a platform, and in Gabon, there's something called sweat bees. They're more like flies, but they would just go like all over your face, so much so that you couldn't even see it sometimes. Long days in the field, I had heat stroke at least once. Being very remote, I was 3 to 4 months at a time with just a couple of other people, not having access to a town really. I mean, we'd go to town maybe like once a month, once every couple of weeks, but the town was incredibly small. I didn't even speak French well, which was the language that most people spoke. So really isolating situations, long days, being away from your family, being away from your friends. This is what field work is really like. So if you can, try to get some experience and see if this career is really for you. That's a wrap up on my wildlife biologist FAQ section. If you have any other questions, please leave them below and I'm happy to create another video to answer them. I would love it if you could subscribe, that way you don't miss out on any future tips. And thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate every single one of you. See you next time. Bye.